with all the proliferation of shows on the Food Network, I think people get a sense of how it really operates back here, but it's really not something you can just show on TV to someone until you've worked on a line, until you've ran a restaurant floor. It's really hard to explain that to someone. In Alberta, I opened 3 brew pubs in the last 4 years, and this will be number 4, fourth brew pub in less than 5 years, which is pretty impressive. You know, opening a new restaurant, you really have to get your team all on the same page. This involves doing a lot of dry runs. So to get this operation up and running, we've had the kitchen going full speed for about 3 weeks. You know, that's 3 weeks of preparing every day, running through the recipes, plating, putting out the food, producing the food, simulating dinner rushes, lunch rushes, and on the front of house, very similar. Not quite as long of a timeline, but to get ready for the opening, we'll run the front of house staff through about 4 or 5 dry runs and really get them used to the systems and the room. And you know, you're bringing a large group of people. For example, we have over 60 people that we brought together for this operation. 60 all new people who don't know each other, new personalities, new relationships to form. So the biggest thing that most people wouldn't know is just how much teamwork and how much effort goes behind actually assembling your team ahead of opening the restaurant. It's been just under a year from the groundbreaking. It's an existing building, but just under a year for the demo and building of the project. So in my experience, that's about standard. That's about how long it takes. And hospitality, it's so easy to make networks within hospitality. It's just such an arms open kind of industry where, you know, people get wind of a project like this and, you know, people are coming to you to see what they can do for you. So, you know, having the two concurrent, a brewery and a restaurant, I think it's more of a benefit than anything. You're able to really showcase your product to the guests because they're looking right at it in between the two. Operational wise, it just means you need a little more communication between your departments. You know, basically you're running a restaurant property with a manufacturing plant on the same site. Developing menus is, it sounds like it's a lot of fun. It's actually probably one of the hardest parts about the opening the establishment, especially in a very competitive market like Vancouver. So I found a chef who was really focused on kind of that communal share plate style of food. We're really just trying to create a menu that's inviting, that's really approachable from a lot of different angles, but also, you know, stepping up above average pub fare as well.